Hi all, my hope is that you're finding okay, you're also keeping safe. I take this opportunity to welcome you to this first class. I've taken notice that not that you are not yet signed in. I've been waiting for you from 2 to now, so I just opted to tape this recording, so I hope you'll find it. But please, next week, let's attend the class, so that we may have a one-on-one lecture, so that I get to know you, you get to know me, and also we get to interact with you. So I'll just go to the first topic of the unit, Introduction to Counseling Psychology. So let's define first what is counseling psychology before we go deeper into it. So according to the website of the Society of Counseling Psychology, counseling psychology as a psychological specialty facilitates personal and interpersonal functioning across the lifespan. So it involves both personal and interpersonal functioning across the lifespan, with a focus on emotional, social, vocational, educational, health-related, developmental, and organizational concern. So this counseling psychology is concerned with all these, whether it is come to emotional matters, social matters, vocational matters, educational matters, even in case you have emotional issues such as stress, even in case you're dealing with social issues such as female genital mutilation, early marriages, those things are still under counseling psychology. They're still under counseling psychology. Vocational issues, educational issues, health-related issues, developmental issues, and organizational concern, they're all under counseling psychology. So it deals with the lifespan, or it's a very wide and a very broad as well as diverse discipline within mental health care, because it involves helping people through mental health care, whether it comes to issues such as emotional, social, vocational, educational. That's why I'm saying it's a very wide and it's a very broad and a wide discipline within mental health care. So it can also lead to many different careers. So since this is our first semester, we'll come to learn about this as you go on. So I want us also to define another term, guidance and counseling. We normally refer to them as one, that is guidance and counseling, but they're two different concepts, though they are related. That's why I'm saying here is a twin concept, and have emerged as essential elements of every educational activity. Guidance and counseling are not synonym terms. They do not mean the same thing. Counseling is a part of guidance. So you'll find counseling is like a child of guidance. So guidance in educational context means to indicate, to point out, to show the way. I'll use this show the way because you're guiding someone. You're guiding someone. So you guide someone while you're still counseling someone. So counseling is a specialized service of guidance. It is the process of helping individuals learn more about themselves. So it's a more specialized stuff. It is an analytical thing. It's go deeper. Guidance is very wide, but when it comes to counseling, it normally narrows down. So it is the process of helping individuals learn more about themselves. You help people learn more about themselves and their present and possible future situations to make a substantial contribution to the society. So definition of counseling, still we are still under definition of counseling. Counseling is essential. Essentially, is a process in which the counselor assists the counselee to make interpretation of facts relating to a choice, plan, or adjustment which he needs to make. That is according to Smith. Another definition of counseling is a series of direct contact with the individual which aims to offer him or her assistance in changing his or her attitudes and behavior. So when it comes to counseling, it's like you give people choices and it's upon them to understand those choices and make or you help assist in changing the attitudes or behavior. Yes. So what about guidance? Guidance is an assistance made available by a competent counselee to an individual of any age to help him direct his or her own life, develop his own point of view, make his own decision, and carry his own burden. You're guiding a person, or you're just showing a person a direction. When you show someone a direction, you don't force them to go. So it's upon them to make the decision whether to go or not by use of that direction. That's why I'm saying guidance is just directing a person to direct his or her own life, develop his own point of view, make his own decision. You don't make a person's decision. They're supposed to be shown the right way. So it's upon them to make the right decision and carry their own burden. So whatever consequences that come with their choice is them to face them. So guidance is a process of helping every individual through his own effort to discover and develop his potentialities for his personal happiness and social usefulness. This is according to Ruth. So I've already defined what is counseling, which is a direct contact between a counselor and a counselee, which aims to help that person make a change in his own attitude or behavior. But for guidance, remember, is showing them the way. So it's upon them to know to make a decision whether to follow that way or not, to make their own decisions, to make their own life choices, all that. So let's see the difference between guidance and counseling. So guidance is a broad and comprehensive, while counseling is in-depth and narrow. So when it comes to counseling, it depends with what you're dealing with. You don't deal with educational matters, sexual matters, social matters in one. You narrow down to the specific aspect that you want to deal with, and then you go deeper into that aspect. When it comes to guidance, you give guidance involving a lot of aspects at the same time. So guidance is more external, helps a person understand alternative solutions available to him, make him understand his personality and choose the right solution. Where in counseling, help people understand themselves and in an inward analysis. Alternative solutions are proposed to help understand the problem at hand. You will help in counseling, you're helping a person either to know to understand the problem they're going through, or to help them know themselves, to have an inward analysis. So when it comes to guidance, it's more external. It helps people understand alternative solutions available to them and make him or understand him or her understand his personality and choice and choose the right solution. Guidance, another difference is guidance is mainly preventive and developmental. You're preventing something from occurring. You're telling people or you're guiding people on the benefits of doing this and this and this and this, and the disadvantages of doing this and this and this and this. So, and this guidance is developmental. As a person grows, or even as you start the guidance and counseling, it normally grows and develops with time. When it comes to counseling, it is remedial. You remind someone, you remind someone of something, as well as preventing and developmental. When it comes to counseling, it's like you're reminding a person, remember taking this and this causes this. It is also preventive because you may prevent something from occurring. Or it is also a treatment process because if you're dealing with a person who is already in a problem, you're kind of helping them out. You're not preventing, you're just helping them out to get out of the problem they're facing. It can also be developmental. Then, another difference is that intellectual attitudes are the raw materials of guidance. When it comes to counseling, emotional attitudes are raw material of counseling process. You're dealing with emotions when it comes to counseling. When it comes to guidance, it's more of like common senses you're dealing with. You're helping people to understand themselves as well as understand the choices that they may make in life and the consequences of those choices. But when it comes to counseling, you're dealing with emotions. Yes. Then decision making is operable at an intellectual level in guidance, but in counseling, it operates as an emotional level. So it's kind of married with the previous point. Guidance is generally education and career related. May also be personal problems. It is educational, or it's an generally education and career related, and may also be personal problems. When it comes to counseling, it's mostly offered for personal and social issues. So majority of the time, when it comes to guidance, you help people make the right career choices, how to choose some career choices, that is education. It can also be personal problems, but when it comes to counseling, majority of them is emotional, personal problems as well as social issues. Then, what is the purpose of guidance and counseling? Number one is to provide the needed information and assistance. You give the needed information and you help them make the right choice. You give them information, yes, but you also guide them on how to make the right choices. It also helps in individuals to make wise choices, yes. Then it another importance, it help improve the understanding of self and facilitate the adjustment. You help a person understand who am I, and then you can help them to adjust to the right way. Once a person understands themselves, they will be able to make the right choices in life and make the right change of behavior. Then it helps in adapting to the changes of new environment. It also helps make self-sufficient and independent, a person to be self-sufficient and independent. So when a person understands themselves, they will be able to adapt to changes in the new environment. It is also the work of, or the purpose of guidance and counseling to ensure that people adapt to the changes of a new environment. So for example, if a person was taking a lot of drugs, it is the work of a counselor person to help that person change and maintain that change of behavior even in future. So they will help adapt to a new environment. If you're moving from one career to the other and you're not comfortable, it's the work of a counselor to help you adapt to the new environment. Making self and thus it, once you're able to adapt to a new environment, you'll be able to make self-sufficient, or to be able to be self-sufficient and independent. You'll not need another person to guide you or to control you once you have gone through counseling and guidance. Then another purpose is efficient use of capabilities and talents. Once a person understands themselves, they're able to know, I have these capabilities, I'm talented in this, and by that you'll be able to use your talents and skills, and thus promote the optional personal and professional development. Then another purpose is balance physical, psychological, emotional, and social, as well as spiritual growth. So it is the work of a counselor to help a person who have no balance of this, because you need a physical, psychological, emotional, social, as well as spiritual growth, and they have to be balanced. You don't deal with one. You can't be very spiritual whereas you're not good when it comes to psychological matters and emotional matters as well as social. Have to go in a balanced way as they grow in you. Then it helps in overall development and to live a productive life. Once a person knows themselves, they're able to make good choices in life. They're able to balance their life when it comes to physical, psychological, emotional, social, all that life. They will be able to understand. They will be able to have an overall growth and to live a productive life. Other functions include to provide optimum development and well-being for individuals, to develop individuals adjust to themselves and the society, or to help individuals adjust to themselves and the society, to help people understand themselves in relation to the world, to aid individuals in efficient decision making, to help individuals plan for a productive life in their social context by focusing on the assets, skills, and strength that they have, to bring about changes in their attitude and behavior of individuals. So all these are purposes as well as the functions of guidance and counseling. So if you are a guidance and a counselor person, if you are a counselee, that is a counselor, you need to provide all this, because your purpose need to be built in these purposes or in these functions of guidance and counseling. So what are the characteristics of guidance? Number one, it's a process. It never ends. It is a continuous process. You can't give one time thing guidance and think that you're done. It is a continuous process. Then choice and problems points are the distinctive concerns of guidance. Choice and problems points. The choice that person makes and the problems that a person may face in life, these are distinctive concerns of guidance. It is the assistant of the individual in the process of development rather than a direction of that development. Then guidance is a service meant for all. When it comes to counseling, it can be a specific individual, but guidance, you guide everyone. Everyone need guidance in life. Then guidance is both generalized and a specialized service. It can be both and generalized and specialized service. You can guide people in a general way, or you can guide people in a special or specialized way. You can use a lot of broad aspect and come together and make them one. But when it comes to, as well as you can just use one concept to guide people. For example, if you're guiding people on career choice, you don't include other things. Deal with career choice only. If you're guiding people on personal choices in life, that is a broad thing, because you include a lot of aspects. But it can either be both. It can either be a generalized or a specialized service. Then guidance is an organized service and not an incidental activity of the school or any place that you need to give guidance. It is an organized service. You just don't give guidance as if it's a song you're reciting. You need to plan yourself. Then guidance is not a branch of any discipline. Is not a branch of any discipline. It's on its own. Then guidance has limits. Guidance is more an art than science. Then guidance has its roots in the educational system. Yes, guidance is centered around the needs and aspiration of clients or students. What are the characteristics of counseling? Counseling involves two individuals, one seeking help and the other professionally trained person who can help the first. So, like a counselee, then there should be a relationship of mutual respect. Before we go to the next point, in the first point, when it comes to guidelines, it doesn't have to be a one-on-one. But when it comes to counseling, we have one counselor and a counselee. But for guidance, you can guide 100 people at a go as compared to counseling, because counseling is more specialized. Or is more narrow, it's normally narrow and depth. Then there should be a relationship between mutual respect, sorry, between the two individuals. They must respect each other. Counseling is aimed at bringing about desired changes in the individuals for self-realization and providing assistance to solve problems through an intimate personal relationship. So you bring desired changes by helping that person realize themselves or understand their inner being, and you help solve the problems they're suffering from by guiding them and making them make the right choices. So the counselor discovers the problems of the counselee and help him to set up realistic goals. So you have, before you come to discover, you have to understand that person first, and hence we are the discovery of the problem will come later. Then if a counselee is a student, counseling helps him to take a decision, make a choice of and find a direction in matters related to an educational program or career. That's under if you're dealing with a student, it helps the counselee acquire independence and develop a sense of responsibility. It is more than advice giving, because you're giving people choices to make. You're giving them, it's upon them to choose. So it involves something more than offering an assistant to find a solution to an immediate problem. So counseling is democratic. You don't force someone. Counseling concerns itself with attitudes as well as actions. Then counseling is centered around the needs and aspirations of the students or the counselee. Then scope for guidance and counseling. Guidance and counseling for personal needs. It can be of personal needs, educational needs, physical, emotional, social, or social, moral, or marital problems. It can also be counseling, guidance and counseling for vocational, occupational, and professional needs. It can also be counseling for career advancement. It can also be guiding and counseling for holistic individual development. It can also be guidance and counseling for situational problems. So this is the scope of guidance and counseling. It can be either personal problem, it can be development of problem, it can be educational and career problems, it can be emotional problems, social problems, moral problems, marital problems. All this comes under guidance and counseling. Why do we need the two? You need the two for personal and social domain. So personal and social development of individuals to adapt to different stages of development. For example, a person, a child that is undergoing a very hard adolescent life, that's a developmental change. So guidance and counseling can help them adapt to different changes in the development. Then offering art of being better living, proper use of leisure time, holistic personal development, best available opportunities, etc. It can also help in with the needs for education and professional domains when it comes to educational growth, professional maturity, facilitation of the of individuals in the right education or profession, career guidance, all this. When it comes to nursing, it will help students when it comes to different environments, depending on what environment that you're dealing with. Then, what are the principles of guidance? So these are the principles of guidance. So all around development of individuals, principles of individual differences, guidance related to each aspects of life, etc., etc. So I want us today, what I wanted us to today to deal with is the introduction to guidance and counseling or counseling psychology. Yes.